Shortly after midnight on the 18th of September 2013, Pavlos Fyssas, a young Greek antifascist rapper, was murdered in his neighborhood of Keratsini, Athens. The killing was part of an organized attack by Golden Dawn, a prominent neo-Nazi group with representation in the Greek parliament and disturbingly strong support amongst the Greek police force. The killer, Georgios Roupakias, was the only Golden Dawn attacker arrested at the scene. Although present during the attack, the police failed to prevent the murder of Pavlos Fyssas, raising serious concerns regarding their role in Golden Dawn's criminal activity. Forensic architecture was commissioned by Pavlos's family and their legal representatives to investigate the events of that night. On the 10th and 11th of September 2018, our video report and findings were presented in the Court of Appeal in Athens, where Golden Dawn is currently on trial. The trial will determine whether Golden Dawn is a criminal organization, bringing their very legitimacy as a political party into question. The investigation was based on the analysis of evidence provided by the court, which included CCTV footage, police radio recordings, and ambulance calls, as well as witness testimony. By examining this material, we established the precise timeline of the events that led to the murder. Since the time on the CCTV cameras was wrongly set, and the police analysis of the footage was incorrect, we began by establishing the correct time for each of the videos. To do this, we had to synchronize the CCTV footage from different cameras, and then link this with audio recordings from the night, some of which had accurate metadata. This newly established audiovisual sequence allowed us to witness the events of the night frame by frame. We could then analyze the movements of the victim, the perpetrators, and the police. Our study confirms the organized nature of the attack and raises a series of questions about the failure of the police who were present at the crime scene to prevent the murder. According to witness testimonies, on the night of the 17th of September 2013, at around 10:30, Pavlos Fyssas was watching a football match with his friends at Korali Cafe in his neighborhood in Keratsini, Athens. Keratsini, a working-class neighborhood, is also known as an area central to Golden Dawn's activities. Also present in this very cafe were three members of Golden Dawn. It was later revealed during the trial in Athens that Pavlos was on a Golden Dawn hit list, likely due to the strong opposition to racism that he expressed through his music. At 10:45, the Golden Dawn members present at the cafe began making a series of phone calls and text messages to fellow members. These communications revealed several aspects of the group's organizational logic. At 11:19, Ioannis Agos called Ioannis Kazatsoglou, who was in charge of security for the local Golden Dawn branch. Kazatsoglou's Golden Dawn membership card and cell phone were later found in the car of the killer, Georgios Roupakias. This combination of digital and physical evidence links him to the crime. At 11:21, Kazatsoglou made a phone call to the head of his local group, Georgios Patelis. Patelis, in turn, called Ioannis Lagos, a member of the Greek parliament representing Golden Dawn. After the conversation with Lagos, at 11:28 and 45 seconds, Patelis sent a group SMS to selected members of the Golden Dawn branch, which read, "Everyone come now to the local office, whoever is nearby. We will not wait for those who are far, now." At this point, Pavlos and his friends were still at the cafe watching the end of the football match. A few minutes before 11:40, according to his testimony, the killer, Georgios Roupakias, arrived at the local Golden Dawn office in Nikea. Outside the office, he met a group of other members on motorcycles, ready to head to the cafe. From there, he followed them to Keratsini in his car. A few minutes later, when Pavlos and his friends left the cafe, they encountered a group of Golden Dawn members awaiting them on the opposite side of the street. Carrying brass knuckles and bats, the Golden Dawn group began to threaten them. Dimitris Hadzistamatis, a prison guard who happened to be present at the scene, began to mediate between the two groups. Pavlos and his friends decided to walk away from the area until things cooled down, leaving behind their cars, as these were now surrounded by Golden Dawn members. They went to the corner of Kefalnias and Tsaldari Street. A few minutes afterwards, at 11:54 and 14 seconds, the motorcycle-mounted special police force, called Dias, received a call from their headquarters, asking them to intervene.
2:03:05:04:01:04.
Στο 400 αυτό είναι ένα κερατσίνι.
Διαβιβάστε.
Από τη συμβολή των Ιφηγενίας και Τσαλδάρης, να βγάλει.
They later claimed that they arrived too late to prevent the killing of Pavlos Fyssas. In order to establish the exact timeline of events, we began by examining, locating, and synchronizing the available CCTV footage. Tsaldari is a busy commercial street, and many of the shops along it have CCTV cameras. One of these cameras captured the attack on Pavlos, while others show the Golden Dawn vehicles, including Rupakias's car, as well as police vehicles and ambulances. Each of these cameras belongs to a different closed system, and most of them were set to the wrong time when installed. The audiovisual assessment that was conducted by the police does not accurately account for the inconsistent times set on the CCTV cameras. We started by locating each camera's cone of vision within a 3D model of the neighborhood. The next step was to track identifiable elements as they moved across different camera frames. This camera, located outside the bank at number 28 Tsaldari Street, was adjacent to another camera from a clothing shop on the same side of the street, at number 40. We noticed three distinct vehicles driving past both cameras: a smart car, a black car, and a white car with a black stripe. We synchronized these cameras by calculating the vehicle's average speed. There were two more cameras situated at number 40, Tsaldari Street. These cameras had partially overlapping cones of vision. We synchronized these three cameras by calculating the average speed of a pedestrian walking through all three visual frames. The two cameras installed on the shops located at numbers 40 and 46 Tsaldari Street captured the same white electricity box. We synchronized these videos by matching the movement of a motorcycle that drove around the box. Following similar clues, we aligned the remaining cameras with one another. The most important CCTV camera was located at number 68 Tsaldari Street. It was facing south, towards the scene of the murder. In the distant background, some 50 meters away, the camera captured the attacks on Pavlos and the movement of the Diaz motorcycles on Tsaldari Street. We synchronized this camera with the rest by calculating the speed of these two cars. Having synchronized all the videos, we were able to determine the sequence of events. However, the videos still lacked an accurate anchor in time. The only reliable source able to provide a timestamp for the sequence was the internal police radio, which accurately records metadata. To anchor the CCTV sequence in time, we needed to synchronize the video footage with these audio recordings. This synchronization was achieved by observing the arrival of the first ambulance to the scene, which was captured across consecutive cameras. The arrival of the ambulance was also announced on the internal communication system of the police.
Διαβάζει παραλυθεί το άτομο, αυτό, 206.
Μόλις προσήλθε ο θαυμός στο ΕΚΑΜ.
We could thus establish that the ambulance arrived just before 12:30. In order to define the exact time of its arrival, we studied other relevant calls that do not have accurate metadata. In this audio recording, the Diaz policeman Christos Deligiannis witnessed the arrival of the ambulance while he was on the phone to an emergency service doctor.
Είστε τα σωροφόρο. Αγγελική, τα σωροφόρο!
Είστε σαλαμίνες.
Έλα, έλα, γιατρέ, είστε τα σωροφόρο.
This phone call lacks metadata. To define the time of this call, we had to synchronize it with other calls that link to the police recordings with accurate metadata. The following synchronization was based on the contents of each call, as well as phonetic analysis. Approximately 20 minutes after Pavlos was stabbed, and as the ambulance was late to arrive, the policemen were discussing the possibility of using a taxi to transfer Pavlos to the hospital. This phone call has an accurate timestamp.
00:02:05:07.
Κέντρο, από ό,τι μας ενημερώνουν εδώ, θα τον παθώ, θα του παραλάβει ταξί. Θα το μεταφέρει στο...
Έχει προσέρθει σε κάπου.
Αρνητικός, αρνητικός, δεν έχει προσέρθει
ακόμα. Και ποιος αποφασίζει για το ταξί, ρε παιδιά.
Κέντρο, είναι εδώ πέρα ο διευθυντής ημέρας.
Α, να αποφασίζει, καλώς.
The Diaz headquarters then immediately contacted the ambulance call center. The exact timing of this phone call is not known. However, its contents fit within the sequence of events as they are described in the timed audio files.
Ορίστε, παρακαλώ.
Μακουτέ, καλησπέρα.
Ναι, γεια σας.
Από την ομάδα δεν σας τηλεφωνώ, από την άμεση δράση, από τον εκφωνητή.
Λες για το, Κερατσίνι.
Ναι, είναι...
από την Νίκη το ένα ξεκίνησε και το άλλο από την πλατεία Κομουνδούρου. Όπου, από
άλλο θέλω να ρωτήσω, καταλαβαίνω ότι γίνεται χαμός σήμερα. Απλά επειδή τώρα λένε να τον βάλουν σε ένα ταξί. Άμα είναι κοντά, τόσο
μισό λεπτό. Όχι, όχι, μισό λεπτό, μην το βάλει σε ταξί.
Φώναξε το βίντεο. Για ρωτήστε πώς είναι κοντά.
Μισό λεπτό θα σου πω, μην το βάλει σε ταξί, μισό λεπτό.
Να ρωτήσω.
Το 525,
το
β21
έχει φτάσει πλησιάζει, πού είσαι?
Ναι, σε λίγο ανεβαίνει η Σαλαμίνος.
Σε ένα-δυο λεπτά είναι εκεί.
Σε ένα-δυο λεπτά είναι εκεί.
Εντάξει, εντάξει. Εντάξει, έγινε.
Εντάξει.
Διαβάστε.
Από το ΕΚΑΒ μας αναφέρουν ότι είναι ο Σαλαμίνος. Σε 2-3 λεπτά θα είναι εκεί.
Recordings from the radio transmissions from the emergency call center to the ambulances also fit within the sequence. Another policeman called the ambulance operator for information. This phone call, too, connects to the previous calls, based on the conversation that unfolded.
S3, λέγεται, παρακαλώ.
Ναι, στην αστυνομία παίρνω.
Ναι, παιδιά.
Για ένα τραυματισμένο άτομο που θα καταλήξει στην Τσαλδάρη, μαχαιρωμένο.
Τσαλδάρη.
Ναι, Τσαλδάρη 60 στο Κερατσίνι.
Τσαλδάρη 60 στο Κερατσίνι.
Ναι, ναι. Το έχουμε πάει πολλές φορές τηλέφωνο.
Σε δύο λεπτά είναι εκεί το ασθενοφόρο, με πληροφορούνε.
Εντάξει, λίγο σύντομα.
Ναι, ναι, παιδιά.
Καταλήγει το άτομο, εντάξει.
Καλώς.
The ambulance center operator in position 3 was informed by another operator who was speaking directly to ambulance B35 about the estimated time of its arrival.
Ναι, Τσαλδάρη 60 στο Κερατσίνι.
Τσαλδάρη 60 στο Κερατσίνι.
Ναι, ναι.
Σε ένα-δυο λεπτά είναι εκεί.
Σε δύο λεπτά είναι εκεί το ασθενοφόρο, με πληροφορούν.
Finally, the last call from the DS policeman to the ambulance center paints a vivid picture of Pavlos's condition just a few minutes before the ambulance arrived.
Δεν έχει τίποτα το παιδί.
Να σας δώσω το γιατρό να δώσετε πρώτες βοήθειες.
Τι μπορώ να τους βοήθησα του τον ανθρώπου, πες μου, τι να του πω.
Προσπαθήσετε να σταματήσετε την αιμορραγία, εάν έχει. Έχει αιμορραγία.
Οδηγείς από το ΕΚΑΠ, μπορούμε να δεχτούμε.
Τι οδηγείς από το ΕΚΑΠ, μη και άδωσε το ΕΚΑΠ. Δεν ξέρω.
Αναπνέει το παιδί.
Δεν ξέρω πώς να τον δω. Πώς να τον δω, φίλε μου. Πες μου, πώς να τον δω.
Είναι κάποιος άλλος εκεί που μπορεί να βοηθήσει, να σας βοηθήσουμε.
Δεν ξέρω,
να χάσει το ασθενοφόρο.
Δεν ξέρω, φίλε μου, το έχει ή δεν έχει βλέμμα το παιδί. Τι να κάνω, πες μου.
Πες μου, πρέπει να το δώσω τον γιατρό.
Είναι με θέματα, πες μου, κάποιον δώσε μου.
Παρακαλώ. Έλα, γιατρέ. Ένα μαχαίρωμα έχουμε στο Κερατσίνι, πάμε. Δεν έχει επαφή.
Ναι.
Αν μπορείτε, δώσετε σε ένα αστυνομικό εκεί πρώτη βοήθεια, γιατί έχει πελαγώσει.
Εντάξει.
Εντάξει, πηγαίνουμε, κοντεύουμε.
Εντάξει.
Ναι, παρακαλώ.
Καλησπέρα.
Καλησπέρα.
Αστυνομία, τηλέφωνο.
Ναι, ναι.
Έχω έναν μαχαιρωμένο στο θώρακα.
Ναι.
Εδώ. Αναμένουμε ασθενοφόρο, επειδή δεν ξέρω πόσες ώρες. Πες μου κάτι, τι να κάνω.
Αναπνέει καθόλου.
Δεν ξέρω. Έχει στιγμό στο παιδί. Έχει στιγμό.
Σε ποιο σημείο του στο θώρακα έχει η μαχαιρωθεί.
Είναι στην αριστερή πλευρά, στο πού θα σου πω, στην αριστερή πλευρά.
Μπορεί να ανάσκελα μπορεί να σταθεί.
Δεν έχει επαφή ο άνθρωπος.
Το μαχαίρι που βρίσκεται είναι απάνω του.
Το μαχαίρι το έχουμε πάρει εμείς. Δεν έχει πληγή. Παρέ, έχει φύγει, ναι.
Βλέπετε να ανεβοκατεβαίνει καθόλου ο θώρακας του.
Όχι.
Καθόλου. Θα μπορέσετε να κάνετε συμπιέσεις να σας δώσω οδηγίες.
Είμαι εύστολος, δεν μπορώ να το κάνω αυτό.
Βλέπετε ένα αιμορραγεί από κάπου.
Με τον γιατρό μιλάω. Τι να κάνετε.
Βλέπετε ένα αιμορραγεί από κάπου.
Έχει σταματήσει αιμορραγεία.
Δεν είναι αιμορραγεί από κάπου.
Έχει υπάρχουν αρκετά αίματα εδώ. Έχει σταματήσει πλέον αιμορραγεία. Το ασθενοφόρο που είναι, Τάσο.
Είναι καθοδόν το ασθενοφόρο, έρχεται.
Είναι καθοδόν. Γιατρέ μου, σου μιλάω. Είναι πόση ώρα.
Το κέντρο μου λέει ότι έρχεται.
Πρέπει να έρθει ο ασθενοφόρος εκεί, πρέπει να έρθει ο ασθενοφόρος, γιατρέ.
Ορίστε.
Έρχεται, έρχεται ο ασθενοφόρος πίσω.
Έρχεται.
Έρχεται ο ασθενοφόρος πίσω. Είστε το ασθενοφόρο. Αγγελική, είστε ασθενοφόρο.
Είστε Σαλαμίνος.
Έλα, έλα, γιατρέ, είστε το ασθενοφόρο.
The voice of the operator can be faintly detected in the background of the second call.
Τσαλδάρι.
Ναι, Τσαλδάρι 60 στο
Κερατσίνι. Τσαλδάρι 60 στο Κερατσίνι.
Ναι, ναι. Το έχουμε πάει πολλές φορές τηλέφωνο.
Σε δύο λεπτά είναι εκεί το ασθενοφόρο με πληροφορούνε.
Τον δώσε μια.
Παρακαλώ. Έλα, γιατρέ.
What follows is the phonetic analysis that was used for the identification of the voice of the operator on the two different sound files.
Σαλδάρι. 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 Σαλδάρι.
Ναι, Σαλδάρι 60 στο Κερατσίνι.
Σαλδάρι 60 στο Κερατσίνι.
Ναι, ναι. Το έχουμε πάει πολλές φορές τηλέφωνο.
Σε δύο λεπτά είναι εκεί. Σε δύο λεπτά είναι εκεί.
Παρακαλώ. Έλα, γιατρέ. Παρακαλώ. Έλα, γιατρέ.
Σε δύο λεπτά είναι εκεί το ασθενοφόρο με πληροφορούν.
Εντάξει, λίγο σύντομα.
Ναι, ναι, παιδιά. Καλώς.
This analysis connects the crucial moment of the arrival of the ambulance to the sound files that have an accurate timestamp. At the end of this call, it is clear that the ambulance is approaching the scene from Salaminos Avenue.
Το κέντρο μου λέει ότι
έρχεται... Δεν πρέπει να έρθει ο ασθενοφόρος εκεί, πρέπει να έρθει ο ασθενοφόρος, γιατρέ.
Ορίστε.
Έρχεται, να έρθει ο ασθενοφόρος πίσω.
Έρχεται.
Έρχεται ο ασθενοφόρος πίσω. Ήρθε το ασθενοφόρο. Αγγελική, είσαι ασθενοφόρο.
Είσαι Σαλαμίνος.
Έλα, έλα, γιατρέ, ήρθε το ασθενοφόρο.
The synchronization was confirmed when, 3 seconds later, the police officers transmitted using the anti-terrorist police channel, which has an accurate timestamp.
Κάπα 206.
Διαβάζει παραλυθεί το άτομο, το 206.
Μόλις προσήλθε ο σταθμός στο ΕΚΑΜ.
The arrival of ambulance B-35 was also visible on the CCTV cameras.
Το κέντρο μου λέει ότι έρχεται...
Δεν πρέπει να έρθει ο ασθενοφόρος εκεί, πρέπει να έρθει ο ασθενοφόρος, γιατρέ.
Ορίστε.
Έρχεται, έρθει ο ασθενοφόρος πίσω.
Έρχεται.
Έρχεται ο ασθενοφόρος πίσω. Ήρθε το ασθενοφόρο. Αγγελική, είσαι ασθενοφόρο.
Είσαι Σαλαμίνος.
Έλα, έλα, γιατρέ, ήρθε το ασθενοφόρο.
We calculated the time necessary for the ambulance to approach the crime scene from Salaminos Avenue based on its average speed as observed on the CCTV cameras.
Κάπα 206.
Διαβάζει παραλυθεί το άτομο, το 206.
Μόλις προσήλθε ο σταθμός στο ΕΚΑΜ.
It was thus possible to anchor the entire CCTV sequence in time. This analysis also confirmed that the audiovisual assessment conducted by the police was vastly inaccurate. The discrepancy between the actual timing of the video footage and that reported by the police was off by up to 20 minutes. This synchronization also allowed us to examine the events of the night, frame by frame, while listening to the police internal communications. Having established the correct sequence of evidence, we were then able to closely examine the 12 crucial minutes surrounding the killing of Pavlos Fyssas. The series of events illustrated within the 3D model were established from our synchronization, as well as from information derived from witness testimony. At 11:54 and 14 seconds, police headquarters alerted the VS teams about the altercation in Keratsini.
408 in Keratsini. Από τη συμβολή των οδών της Ιθυγενίας και Τσαλδάρη, της Ναυδιάλη.
Ένα τέσσερα.
Το 26 είναι καταβαλή. Διαβιβάστε. Για εσάς η διέπινα 26 είναι για
Κερατσίνη, στη Γενία και Κωνσταντίνου Σαλδάρη. Είναι 50 άτομα στο σημείο Νερόπαλα και κατευθύνονται προς το κατάστημα Κοράλι. Ελίθι.
Σαλδάρη, έφερε.
Στη Γενία.
Καλώς.
At 11:58 and 11 seconds, the Diaz motorcycles arrived at the scene. This contrasts with police testimony which claimed that they did not even receive the call from their headquarters until 1 minute later, at 11:59. The video shows two teams, each made up of two Diaz motorcycles, arriving at the scene. However, for reasons unknown, 3 minutes later, one of the teams transmitted to the radio that they were alone at the scene. At 11:59 and 8 seconds, a convoy of 8 motorcycles followed by 2 cars arrived on the scene. The first of these, a silver Nissan Almera, matches the description of the car of the killer, Georgios Rubakias, who later testified to have arrived in Keratsini by following a Golden Dawn convoy from the group's local headquarters. At this point, the convoy must have turned left onto Kefalonia Street, as it is no longer visible on the main camera that captures the next intersection along Tsaldari Street. A few seconds later, at 11:59 and 40 seconds, the Diaz police reappeared on camera. This indicates that they must have driven around the block following their arrival at the scene. This additional turn was not included in any of the police testimonies. By their accounts, the Diaz teams parked their motorcycles on Kefalonia Street, close to the Golden Dawn group. At the same time, according to Pavlos' friends, Rupakias stopped his car in front of them. From the driver's seat, Rupakias purportedly asked Pavlos if he knew where Kefalonia Street was, thus identifying him before the attack. According to Rupakias, when he arrived outside Korali Cafe, the Diaz policemen were still dismounting their motorbikes. This confirms that the police were present at the scene before the attack on Pavlos began.
Κέντρο επί της Σαλδάρης έχει κατά καργονία αρκετά άτομα και της Παύλου Μελάκη και Κεφαλινίας έχει γύρω στα 20 άτομα, 20 άτομα της Χρυσής Αυγής, όπου μας ενημερώνουν ότι είχαν μια διαμάχη με κάτι άτομα του γνωστού χώρου. Είμαστε πλησίων να προσπαθούμε να κατευνάσουμε τα πνεύματα.
Συγκλείω και το πέραμα.
Και εδώ να βρείτε, από ό,τι διακρίνουμε, υπάρχουν και κάτι σιδεροπουνιές, κάτι ρόπαλα.
At this moment, we can see increased activity at the top of the video.
Υπάρχουν και εδώ μόνο η ομάδα μας.
Κάτε σαφά. Ακριβές ανέτοικα που βρίσκεστε.
According to the witness testimony of Dimitris Hadzistamatis, as Pavlos and his friends were leaving a few seconds later, the Golden Dawn group began to chase them, running past the policemen.
Υπάρχει μια ένταση και το παράκλειο να έρθει και μια ομάδα ακόμα. Να το έρθει η Ροδοτσόνα, να το έρθει κάποια ομάδα.
Παραμείνετε σε απόσταση να μας δίνετε εικόνα. Θα προσθέτουν και τρεις ομάδες.
Pavlos and his friends started running down Taldari Street.
Βλέπουμε κάτι άτομα κυνηγάνε τις χιάλφα, κυνηγάνε έτερα άτομα της Ταλδάρης, κυνηγάνε για να τους πιάσουν.
As his friends managed to flee, Pavlos stayed behind and was attacked by the Golden Dawn squad, close to number 60 Tsaldari Street. According to witness testimony, small teams of Golden Dawn members took turns, crossing the street and attacking Pavlos. We can see faint traces of these attacks in the distant background of the video.
Τετραγώς αυτό ένα, βλέπετε ακόμα άτομα να κυνηγάνε.
At this point, the killer's car enters the visual frame and the killer, Γιώργος Ροπακιάς, is visible scouting out the scene.
Είμαστε της κεφαλινίας και έτσι στα εσωρά στις αλδάρες, το σκλαμπράκι, δεν τις βλέπουμε τώρα, θα προσεγγίσουμε.
Για τις ομάδες που συγκλίνουνε, 410 πέραμα, ό,τι άτομα βλέπουμε να τρέπεται στη φυγή, λαχανιασμένο, μας ενημερώνετε. Το δεσμεύουμε μέχρι να ενημερωθούμε.
Πέραμα της Ταλδάρης!
Να πέτε.
Πέραμα της Ταλδάρης!
307.
Then, Ροπακιάς drove into Tsaldari Street against the direction of oncoming traffic. As the attack on Pavlos unfolded, transmissions from the DS units stopped for about a minute and the radio was completely silent. Studying the movement of the car, as well as the activity of the figures captured in the video, we established that the murder took place between 12:03 and 23 seconds and 12:04 and 6 seconds. Despite its low resolution, the camera at number 68 Tsaldari Street captured the murder itself. According to witness testimony, Pavlos was surrounded by 3 to 4 Golden Dawn members at the moment when Ροπακιάς approached him. Looking closely, several figures wearing black clothing and what appear to be white helmets start appearing at the scene. These figures bear a similarity to the appearance of uniformed DS policemen who reportedly keep their white helmets on when there is an altercation. Moments later, the police announce their arrival at the scene.
Πόσα τα άτομα, πόσα τα άτομα που εμπλέκονται.
More figures in black clothing with white heads gradually entered the scene, moving back and forth between the location where Pavlos was found wounded and where Ροπακιάς had parked his car.
Έχουν σπάσει τα στενά, άτομα της Χρυσής Αυγής και αλλοδαπή, για να καταλάβουμε. Είναι τις ομάδες που συγκλίνουν το σημείο.
In contrast to the Golden Dawn members who fled the scene immediately, these figures remained on camera for several minutes after the attack.
Από πέρα με άτομα της Χρυσής Αυγής, βλέπουμε άτομα να τρέχουν προς Κεφαλινίας.
Προς Κεφαλινίας, στην Αμφιάλη. Άτομα της Χρυσής Αυγής πεζά, έχουν τραπεί σε φυγή.
Ελίθεια από νίκια.
Κέντρο, ανέβη το δημοτικό.
402 είναι και εσείς για το σημείο. 400 α2 το έχετε λάβει.
Θα έχω να πει άπαλα και κατευθύνομαι για την ομάδα με πολύ προσοχή.
At 12:05 and 20 seconds, Anastasios Tsolakidis, the chief of one of the VS groups, reported to his headquarters that Pavlos Fyssas was injured. This study confirms the organized nature of the attack and raises a series of questions about the presence of Thea's police at the scene. Why did the police officers lie about the time of their arrival and their movements prior to the attack? And why, despite their close proximity, did they fail to prevent the attack and the murder of Pavlos Fyssas? Rupakias was arrested on site and apprehended by police unit A82. Officer Dimitrios Kouratzis, of the same unit, reported that when he picked up the discarded murder knife, he asked Rupakias, "Is this yours?" Rupakias replied, "Yes, it is mine. I did it, but don't give me away. I am one of you." "What do you mean? Are you police?" asked the officer. "No," the killer replied. "I am Golden Dawn."